Hello everybody and welcome back to Crafts with Louisa. Last week I showed us a craft that would remind us that nothing is impossible with God. We named it finger painting camel because Jesus was saying it would be impossible for a camel to fit through the eye of a needle. Like the rich man, it would be impossible for him to get into heaven because he loved his money too much. He didn't honor and love God. He loved things on this earth, so that was a reminder for us to love Jesus, to love God most, even when there's things in our life that we really like to have, and that nothing is impossible with God. It's not about anything that we could do here on earth, any good thing we could do, but because God sent Jesus to save us from our sins, to die on the cross, and that's how we can go to heaven. This week, I will be doing a craft that will remind us of our story from our kindergarten to grade one class, and they are learning about the early church. So in the early church, they had an issue, and their issue was that they were showing favoritism. They were showing favoritism to different types of people, so maybe there would be someone who looked rich, they had fancy clothes, and they were more welcoming to them than they would be to poor people, maybe who didn't have as many nice things. And that's not what Jesus asks of us. He wants us to love everybody and to be welcoming to everybody and to share his love with all those around us, not just people who look like us or maybe who have fancy things or maybe someone who's super cool in your classroom, but he wants us to be friends with everybody, to share his love with everybody, and to be welcoming just the same, even when people look different than us or maybe don't have as many things as us. So I'm going to share a verse with us that will remind us of that today, and then we're going to make our craft. So this verse is found in the book of John, and it is chapter 13, starting in verse 34, and it says, "So now I am giving you a new commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other. Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples." So Jesus was instructing us that if we love him, we will love others because he loved us first. He demonstrated his love for us. He showed us how much he loved us and he was kind to us. And he wants us to love others around us. And by doing that, we show them how much God loves them too. So that is his commandment for us or his instructions for us. So I'm going to be making a craft today that will remind us to love one another. So watch this. Alright, I have finished my craft for today. It's this little card and it says, "This is my commandment, that you love one another." And when you open it up, my handprints make a heart shape. It's kind of like a stained glass window heart. And that was our verse of the day, which is John 13, 34. And that is Jesus asking us and commanding us or reminding us to love those around us. So even when they look different than us, or even when we don't want to be their friend or they've done something mean to us, he wants us to love everybody the way that he has loved us. So we don't even deserve his love, but he loves us. And he wants us to love others around us as well. And that's his commandment. That means something that he's asking of us so we can honor him by following him and by obeying his commandment. So that's my challenge for us all this week, to love others, to think about something we could do practically or to be kind to someone, to love them and remind them that we love them because God loves us first. So this is our craft for today, and I hope it's a good reminder for you of our lesson. Our Firelight classes have been doing online lessons, so this was for our grade K to 1 class, and our grade 2 to 5 class have been learning about when Jesus cleansed the temple. And those Bible story videos will be posted on YouTube on Sunday morning for you to watch as a family. And I'd love to hear from you if you have any questions or hear what you've been learning or if there's anything that I can pray for you for. And I hope we'll be able to meet in person again soon. But for now, you can always reach me by email. My email is louisa@redeemerbible.ca, and I'd love to hear from you. I hope you enjoyed this craft this week, and I'll see you next time.